Hello, it's an honor to join you at the White House Tribal Nations Summit. The Biden-Harris administration has called on us to strengthen our commitment to Indian country. USDA is taking that call to heart as we look at new opportunities to build a platform of trust and respect. To that end, I'm pleased to introduce the new Hall of Tribal Nations, hosted in the office of the Secretary at the United States Department of Agriculture. For years, USDA has welcomed state governors with flags from each of the 50 states. Now we can welcome you with your flags. This Hall of Tribal Nations embodies our unique diplomatic relationship and trust responsibility with you as dignitaries of your own tribal nations. As you move through this hall to visit USDA's Office of Tribal Relations, we want to welcome and honor you with elements of your nations and communities. Not only will this hall host your flag, you'll also see Native artwork donated from across Indian country, representing the diversity of indigenous cultures and creativity. There's one piece of artwork in particular for the hall I want to take a moment to share. This piece was created by Cheyenne River Sioux Tribal member Kimberly Dolphus Gulf to honor Secretary Holland. We at USDA want to acknowledge the historic importance of Secretary Holland's appointment as the Secretary of the Interior and thank her for her leadership. Thank you to the tribal nations who have graciously gifted their flags to us thus far, and the Native artists who have lent us their beautiful works of art. If you see fit to honor us with your tribal flag or share additional art, please know you will find a welcome home at the Hall of Tribal Nations. I also want to share with you a special announcement, the launching of USDA's Indigenous Food Sovereignty Initiative. USDA is, of course, a leader in food and agriculture, but our programs and priorities have not always reflected indigenous values, foods, and traditional agricultural techniques. This initiative will be a multifaceted one as USDA rethinks food and agricultural programs from an indigenous perspective. We welcome your guidance and input on this journey together. As a small gesture of this new commitment, we're displaying and distributing Native-produced and indigenous foods in my Office of Tribal Relations to support indigenous foods and Native producers, and to educate USDA and others of their importance and their role. As a first step of many for the Indigenous Food Sovereignty Initiative today, I'm also announcing 7 new cooperative agreements with my office to help us lead the way. We're partnering with the Native American Food Sovereignty Alliance, Indigenous Seed Keepers Network, to promote indigenous seed saving practices and policies. We also want to promote wild and indigenous food foraging, and we'll be producing a series of videos on how to do so sustainably with ethnobotanists Linda Black Elk and Lisa Ironclad. And some of you may know Chef Sean Sherman, also known as Sous Chef. Well, we're going to produce video series with him on cooking wild and indigenous foods. To support our Native producers, we're partnering with the Intertribal Agriculture Council to begin a domestic marketing initiative and to purchase Native-produced and indigenous food products to populate the Hall of Tribal Nations. We're working with the Intertribal Buffalo Council to create a manual on transitioning from cattle to bison for those producers that might be interested. And finally, to help us better empower our tribal partners, we're partnering with the University of Arkansas Indigenous Food and Agriculture Initiative to help us rethink what tribal self-governance might look like in our food programs. And we look forward to partnering with you on the Indigenous Food Sovereignty Initiative and to welcoming you in person to the Hall of Tribal Nations once our headquarters officially reopens to the public. Thank you for your continued advocacy on these important issues, and I look forward to our conversations throughout the Tribal Nations Summit.